Yo guys, Jonathan here. 18 cores and iMac are probably two things you would never expect to say in the same sentence, but with the iMac Pro, that is a thing. This is the fastest iMac Pro you can buy. 18 cores, AMD VEGA 64 graphics, 128 gigabytes of RAM, and a 4 terabyte SSD. So I've got a chance to spend the last couple days with this monster of an iMac, and I really wanted to focus on performance. For reference, I'll be showcasing it against a 10-core Vega 64 iMac Pro, as well as an 8-core Vega 56 model. So jumping into the obligatory Geekbench 4 score, because honestly, it's just kind of fun to see where these 18 cores stacked up. This did not disappoint with a multi-core score of over 48,000. Now, what was a little surprising but also positive is you don't lose that much in terms of the single core score compared to the 10 core and 8 core model, especially considering that the base clock on this is 2.3 gigahertz. Also, what was kind of interesting for me, this is the first time I've got a chance to stack up the 1 terabyte, 2 terabyte, and 4 terabyte SSD configurations. The bad news is the 4 terabyte really isn't much faster than the 2 terabyte or 1 terabyte for the matter. But on the flip side of that, the good news is no matter which route you go, you're gonna get pretty much the same performance across the board. Now, as far as how that power translates into performance, the first thing I did was take 8K raw footage. It was about 100 gigabytes or just over 26 minutes of footage, and transcode that into 8K ProRes. To do this, I used Red Cine X program, which really puts those cores to work. Like, it was maxing them out. With the 18 cores, especially when you factor in multiple threads, seeing 36 instances run at the same time is kind of a beautiful thing. As far as what those cores translated to, the 18 core iMac Pro took a little over 39 minutes, the 10 core was 46 minutes, and the 8 core iMac Pro did the job in just about 51 minutes. Now, your initial reaction might be 5-6 minutes, that's not that big of a deal, but where it counts is when you do that multiple times per day, then multiply that every day for a week, for a year, that's where that really makes a difference. So next up is Cinema 4D. This is a custom scene that was tweaked by my buddy Matt Workman. Essentially, it is only using the CPU to render out the scene, so it's a great way to showcase the performance between the processors. The 18 core rendered everything out in 4 minutes flat, the 10 core was 4 minutes and 48 seconds, while the 8 core finished everything up in 6 minutes and 4 seconds. Again, much like the Red raw transcoding, these numbers and this time saved on a small scale might not seem like the biggest deal, but over time, it definitely adds up. From there, jumping over to Final Cut Pro 10, Red RAW, the iMac Pro, and Final Cut Pro have been amazing. To give you a little rundown on this project, I have 8K Red RAW footage at a 12:1 compression. This was shot in Red's IPP2 logs, have a LUT applied, a few different layers of color correction, and then I have background rendering off to really put these iMac Pros to work. So the raw timeline, which is unrendered, is about 3 minutes, and taking that and exporting it to a ProRes 422 file, the 18 core iMac Pro did that in 5 minutes and 51 seconds, the 10 core 6 minutes and 34 seconds, and the 8 core 7 minutes and 22 seconds. Even though the 10 core iMac Pro still has the fastest single threaded turbo clock speed, in this case you can see, in terms of Final Cut, the extra cores do actually make a difference. In my continued search of programs that really take advantage of the processing power though, Screenflow 7 actually takes really big advantage of all those cores with the iMac Pro. What it did was take a 5K screen recording, had a 3-minute project, and then exported that into 4K H.264 footage. The 18 core iMac Pro did that in 1 minute 48 seconds, the 10 core 2 minutes and 24 seconds, and lastly the 8 core iMac Pro 2 minutes and 46 seconds. Now I did mess a little bit with Adobe Media Encoder. I took A6500 footage, is about 10 minutes of 4K video. I tried to transcode that into 422 ProRes. The 18 core did that in 6 minutes 54 seconds. The 8 core was 8 minutes and 36 seconds, but for some reason, the 10 core was actually slower than the 8 core at 10 minutes and 8 seconds. But from what I can tell, Adobe Media Encoder really wasn't taking advantage of all that hardware. I'm gonna do a little more research and a little more investigating, but I did wanna share those preliminary Adobe results first. Now, plot twist, those motion graphic benchmarks featured throughout this video were created in After Effects, so naturally I thought it would make sense to render them out on these iMac Pros. So for a total of 6 independent renders, the 18 core iMac Pro finished everything up in 10 minutes and 36 seconds. The 10 core was actually the fastest here at 9 minutes and 43 seconds, and then the 8 core iMac Pro did the job in 12 minutes and 19 seconds. So these numbers kind of tell me a couple different things. One, the clock speed on the 10 core iMac Pro here in this case definitely makes a difference. And two, based off those comparisons against Adobe Media Encoder, Adobe is clearly not taking full advantage of the hardware on these iMac Pros. Honestly, I still think the 10 core iMac Pro is the best value in terms of bang for your buck with performance, but if you need that sheer processing power, power, those 18 cores really come in handy. Now, if you line up the 8, the 10, and 18 core, in my case, the only one I haven't checked out yet is the 14 core. In terms of price and what you gain performance-wise, it's a pretty even jump. So if you transcode a ton on a day-to-day basis or potentially use really CPU-intensive programs like Cinema 4D, that's maybe where those extra cores come into play. But if you're asking me, I still think, again, the best bang for your buck is the 10-core iMac Pro, but nonetheless, the 18-core iMac Pro is a super solid performer. It is very, very powerful. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did and you are feeling like being awesome, make sure you guys smash that like button. This is Jonathan, and I will catch you guys later.